We're using the pollen trap to collect the pollen, and in this case we use the simple yellow ones. They don't fit at any colony, but you can make some adjustment as we did here with a wooden block to fit on the hive entrance. There are a lot of pollen traps applied all over Europe, so you have to adjust your own one. We mounted this one to this colony. And to collect pollen, we insert the pollen basket below it. This is how it looks like. In the pollen trap we have a simple tool. This is this piece of iron. Click it, take it, and there it is. To make a combination of the pollen trap and the beehole tube, we made this box, simple box, with two tubes through which the bees will leave the hive, and later on we insert the beehole tubes. We place this box in the pollen trap. Simple as that. We seal it off. Seal it off to the other side. So now the bees have to leave and enter the hive through this box. It takes the bees about one day to get used to this new entrance. And when they're used to enter the hive through these holes, we introduce the beehole tubes. Now, demonstrate them. Simply insert this in this box. That's it. After 14 days, we replace the beehole tubes. That means we take the old ones out. Put them in the blue cap tube. Take the other one out. Then I'm going to get the new innovation of this Insignia project is the AP strip. It's a strip covered with a certain material, Tenax. And Tenax is a material that absorbs the molecules of the pesticides. We're going to insert this in the bee lane. I'll show you how to do it. Open the hive, give gentle smoke, wait a sec, the bees will be wandering around and will be in touch with this AP strip, and I place it in the middle of the colony here, drop it, simple as that. So this is the insertion of the AP strip.
Yeah. Yeah, close the colony, yeah.
Close the hive. Two weeks later. Open the hive. Give it a gentle smoke. Here we have the AP strip, take it out gently, hardly any piece on it, try to, and I wrap it in aluminium foil And now it's ready for sending to the laboratory.
Yeah. And then you close the box.
Demonstrate how we collect bee bread samples. So open up the hive. Give a gentle smoke. Check for the bee bread. No bee bread in this one. Okay, we have bee bread here.
Yep.
Remove bees. Close the hive partly. To collect the bee bread, we have this special pollen picker, and it's made of a straw. I can show you here. Of simple straws. And let me show you how to do it. We have this straw. Insert it, turn a bit, and take off. Here you have one pollen sample. Then we have to take 20, so go to the next straw. Two. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and with 10 samples your straw is full. This we wrap in aluminium foil to be sent to the laboratory. In the laboratory, the pollen bee bread will be pushed out for the bird. And it looks like this. I made a device for the pollen bee hole tube without the combination with the pollen trap. And I made a simple strip, and you can make it yourself and put it in front of the hive. Tape it there. Or attach it in another way you would like it to have attached. Here's an opening, so we seal this off using styrofoam. So now the bees will enter and leave the hive through these holes. They preferably will use this one, and after a day we're gonna insert the beehole tubes I showed you before. So here's the beehole tube, and just insert it. So this is the beehole tubes. After 14 days we will replace them. Now I can show you, just simply take them out, put them back in the tool cap for sending to the laboratory, and the same with the other one. So they can be sent to the laboratory, labeled and sent to the laboratory.